The 10739 Shark Attack is the only LEGO Ninjago movie set from the Juniors line. It has 108 pieces and it features Kai on a motorcycle, a shark vehicle, and a couple of training stuff. Shark Attack is set in four different sections, so let's go ahead and start off with the main build. The main build is of course this shark car. The shark car is a very simple build since it is a junior set and there's not a lot to it. There's a little bit of articulation you can get since these fins on the side are opposable, so there is a little bit of expression you can actually get from the car. For what it is with the small build, they do have some nice details in there, such as these printed sort of danger police tape-like pieces located on the side for his arms, and of course the teeth on the bottom, as well as the number 4 located on the hood. The actual car doesn't really have any play features though, aside from these flickfire missiles, which, you know, as they are, they're just flickfire missiles, so you just, you know, kind of come in and flick them, and they work decent, but you know, they can be kind of difficult to use at times. There's also a clip on the back, which is just nice because it's just a way for you to store the Shark Army Warrior's weapon. Although it looks kind of awkward, it is just kind of nice and convenient, and I'm happy that they did put it in. There's also, of course, these small little yellow highlights on the back, which don't really serve any purpose aside from being highlights, and I think they work well here. The shark vehicle also does have a small interior with a console piece. Kai's motorcycle is the simplest of the builds since it is just a generic LEGO motorcycle, which is basically just two pieces put together. However, there is a little bit of detailing on it. On the front there is some printing, which is nice, and it just adds a little more detail to the motorcycle, but the main detailing is on the back. The back of course has a flame coming out along with a flag, which of course you can adjust a little bit, you can move it around, and you can adjust this flame too, you can move it like this if you really want to. It's just a small little bit of detailing. And the only issue I really have with this motorcycle is that it can be kind of annoying to balance. And lastly are these two little just training builds. The first one here is more like this ninjutsu training build, where it has this small little tower which you can just spin around pretty easily, and it works well for what it is. And then there's also a little weapon rack which has just one black katana. However, the most interesting thing here is actually the new piece used to give off that new detailing, which looks nice. The other one is even simpler than the other one, with it really just having pretty much no detail, and all you really do is just break the wood and sort of kind of just build up strength, and then there's also two sides located in a bucket. The three minifigures included in this set are Kai, Spinjitzu Training Lloyd, and Great White. Spinjitzu Training Lloyd is exclusive to this set, and he does come with this hairpiece, which is pretty cool, and you can see they do have some nice printing. On the back you can see, once again, some nice printing, but when you remove the armor from Great White and Kai, you can see even more printing, as well as some alternate faces for Kai and Lloyd, and you can see what the alternate faces look like. It's also worth mentioning that you cannot do anything in regards of head articulation with Great White, because his armor is actually molded onto his headpiece, which is unfortunate. Overall, the Shark Attack is good. It's not the best set out of the line, but it is pretty solid, especially for a junior set. The builds you get are all good. They all offer some decent playability, and the minifigures are really good as well. Kai in particular is great just because you get all the accessories, and Lloyd is good as well since he is exclusive, as well as that new hairpiece. Great White is okay. I mean, he could be better if they would have just allowed the head articulation, but he is still good. The builds also are solid. I particularly like the car, the shark car. I think that is the best build and you get the most playability out of it, but all the other ones are solid and still offer nice playability. And that is pretty much it for this quick review on the Shark Attack set. Thank you guys for watching. Until next time, this is HF Masters saying goodbye.